So Penelope is done with her food and feed. So this will be third time that I've led her around the barn. And the second time I've put her blanket on her, which actually is a bareback saddle, but that's what I like to use. Right, baby girl? And she is sweet, sweet, sweet. But she's five again, and we've had her a month. Right? Facility born Mustang. And the way to pick one like this, or to have any chance of picking a Mustang as sweet as she is to go to the facility and hand pick. Don't go online and pick a pretty one. Go to the facility and hand pick, which is what we did with her. Right, baby girl?
Yes, Mama. Yes, Mama. I picked you, you picked me.
Okay, so third time. Second time, the blanket. See how this goes. And I don't like to, you know, throw her halter on her, desensitized to it. That's not something that she needs to be afraid of in the first place. I don't like to throw her blanket on her, desensitize her to it, because, again, she doesn't need to be afraid of it in the first place. And I've already established that I'm alpha, so what I am afraid of, she is afraid of. So, we're not afraid, so we're just gonna proceed. Leslie, right, my dear?
Hmm? Hey, whatever you say.
What she's been used to every day. I brush her and I talk to her. What's Abbott doing? What's he doing? Coming in here with us?
That's caught on her ear.
Kind of did it. Did I mess up? Yeah. So here I'm touching her ear. And I'm not doing it very forcefully, but I'm doing it because she's got to get used to it anyhow. And so that's actually her being trained to be used to it. And I kind of use that technique every time I mess with her. Go a little bit further on the way I touch her. A little bit further on the way we interact, and she accepts it because it's so minute it barely registers to her. Right, girl?
Hey, girl, lady.
That's basically all she ever says to me. There she goes. Okay, so since I started with her feet, I want to continue with her feet, although at this point she really doesn't need them done like she did previously. I just don't want to backtrack on any of my training. So what I'm doing is I'm tapping her feet, just asking her to pick them up, and then eventually I'll touch the bottom of her hooves with my brush. And you know, every time I ask her, I'll go just a tad further, and that's how I'm going to get her used to it without a big blowout. That's the plan anyhow, right, girl? Okay. Come on, Pippa. Good girl. And I judge how she's feeling every day and how much I can push her just by how her body is reacting to me. Right now, she's really nervous. When I asked her to pick up her foot, she didn't do it immediately. So I can tell she's on right now. So I don't want to push her too hard. So I'm not going to. So you have to be able to read your horse too. Right now she's telling me, Mama, I'm nervous. I don't know what's going on today. Dan's over there moving around with that camera. I don't know. But I'm going to push forward. Good girl. Good job. And that was perfect. We're gonna get some attention. Up. Up. She's trying to pull away again. Yeah, she's nervous. Not wanting to hurt herself. When she flips the rope out, it might hit her and scare even more. Hit. Come on. Hit. Yep. Come on. Yep. This is where the patience comes in. When you're for real, first training, non-touch horse. Just thinking. There we go. Good girl. Good girl. And she decided. I put a little bit of pressure on her and she decided. Good job. So she gets a reward. Hmm? See, her reward is good job and good. Good girl. Do a little bit more brushing. Getting the butt. Got a cute butt. Yeah, we got a cute butt. Nice flat back. And, you know, some trainers say talk, don't talk, whatever. I talk. Beatrice making you nervous too, girl? My brush. See, she's extra nervous today, aren't you? Oh, don't be. Oh, don't be. It's okay. It's okay. Don't be nervous. Me too. She's a good girl. Yeah, she's a good girl. She goes pulling back again. Pull her forward some more. Come on. So she knows she's gotta stand up here. This is where I want her. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Right, girl? Come on. Just thinking. A little bit of pressure on her. Good. Afraid of it. I don't want her to emphasize her to it. I want her just to think of anything else. Nothing to be afraid of.
Back up.
Back up. Too close, girl. Too close. Alright. Brush is getting you this morning, huh? So Penelope, even though she seems super calm, like I said before, she's got her finger on the panic button. Hmm? There are still waters on the horse, right? Ask again. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. You're pulling too far. And I like to go around the face instead of around the butt for obvious reasons. That's this one. Good girl. And that's all I'm asking. And when I first started out, she would go to nip me, tell me, hey, get away from my feet. Now she doesn't. Yep. Yep. Too much pressure. Too much pressure. Come on. Focus on me. No, with the ears. She's like, Mama, I want something to drink. I had my grain. I can tell that I'm thirsty. Can I smell it? You want to eat it again? Okay. Easy. Easy. She tolerated it. Her thoughts are elsewhere on Dan. Now we're gonna do some lead work, and this is her third time leading. We'll go around the stall here. Thank you. finish on a bad note, regardless, how much time it takes to get them to finish where you want them to finish, you have to watch. I want her to finish in the stall. So, cameraman, can you open up the stall for me? What's up, buddy? Okay. Yep. I always want the stall to be where they dress and undress, so to speak. Come on, Bob. At least at first. Come on. Yep. Yesterday we had trouble getting her to go back in also. Looks like, I'll follow you. What you got? What you got? No. Hey. No, sir. Pick up. Up. No. I'm going to have to put you away, too. All right. Yep.
Back up, 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 there you go.
Yep. All else fails.
These reeds work.
Good girl. But I will just rope her first on the opposite side. Let's see how she does. Good girl. Good job. She knows she comes in here, she gets undressed, and then she gets. Up.